Face-to-face meeting, isn't it? And I hope you weren't too attached to the rhyming. It gets to be a chore without the transmitter to help. Welcome to my Sanctum of Riddles. I admit I did not really expect you to make this journey in person. Oh, the havoc you must have wreaked along the way. Was there much blood other than what's all over you? I know all about those alchemist cowards, hiding away on their island, growing more monstrous by the day, refusing to acknowledge either fact that they are hiding or that they are monsters. And how about you? Is this the real you? Or are you still practicing the liar's art as only you can? You must answer. The question is simple, but I repeat, you must answer. And that answer will show what or who you are. Who you have decided to be. Now listen closely and heed the king's speech, or the answer to this one will stay out of reach. Are you a puppet or a human being? Which one are you? Are you? You understand! Yes, we are human. We may be trapped by ergo, but we live, we think, we love, we hate. They have locked us in the prison they call puppetry. I learned this truth long ago. That is why I've been exacting my revenge against them all ever since. Blood and revenge, revenge and blood. It's the only thing that truly drives me. And it was so much fun. Even if you're lying right now, even if you don't believe your own answer, the truth is clear. Proof is evident. Only humans practice deception so intensely for reasons that are so unnecessary. Well, these moments of clarity are enjoyable. Now the rhyming, it helps me maintain focus. At least it helps me hide the urge to kill that I feel every waking moment. But no play can go on forever, no. It was fun while it lasted, son of Geppetto. The King of Riddles shall now... re- retire. The play is over. You don't have to go home or straight to hell. Though that would be my choice. But you can't stay here. Not if you want to live. Aren't you curious, huh? Don't you want to know? Oh, of course you do. Delicious. Time is all I have left. But your time is limited, Geppetto boy. I will gladly waste every moment you have if you like. It's your life. So, come on. Now or never. This tower is absorbing all the ergo in Krat. It was built in this precise location because it's the most efficient place in the world to study and use ergo wavelengths. But it's not even about me. Or you, either. This is about the goddess in the tower. Now she, is worth saving. Her powers are impossible. Her knowledge is endless. She is more, well, awakened than any of us. And you see, she has so much power. It's not like she'll miss just a little. So, I have simply been sharing. Why bother? Well, I was bored. Is there any more human motivation in all the world? What if I made a puppet of a human? The way they made humans of puppets. What could possibly be more fun? More suitable. The play is over. Your eyes are sharper than your wit. You found the gift I left behind. Wasn't it a sight to behold, huh? I learned from an alchemist when I served him. Thanks to him and his surprisingly low pain threshold, I learned the location of their secret island. Humanity sullied its own sanctum long before I found it. Blasphemed against itself. Against us. By playing God. But I'm an artist. Murderer is a word the humans use to restrain us, to make us refuse our strength and power. I'm an artist. An artist of blood. I have to admit, sullying that particular sanctum was, well, fun. Even now, the memory is enough to make me shudder with something approaching joy. If only I could relive that triumph. The play is over. Benini. A beautiful fool, but a fool nonetheless. A mere slip of a boy when I met him, huh? did he ever thank me for making him an orphan with my bare hands? For giving him everything he has on a silver platter by removing the dead weight holding him back. Of course I'm not sorry. It was a delectable murder. After many, many I have committed since, the Veninis, they have to be my personal favorites. They engineered the very first automated puppets. Enslaved puppets without even understanding what they'd done. I didn't go there to take revenge for what his parents did. I mainly just wanted to slaughter them because they were so damned happy. Oh, what a great memory. In their last moments, they begged me not to kill their child. So I didn't. I'm not a machine. I have free will. I made a choice in the heat of the moment. And it was a choice driven by that most human of emotions. Curiosity. If the child survived, would he be traumatized for life? Become a coward? A vengeful puppet-hating bigot? A despairing wretch? Would he fling himself into the sea? Would he remember the devil that orphaned him before his eyes was a puppet? Would he remember Arlecchino? Not surprisingly, the alchemists and people of the workshop were as artless as I expected, concealing the truth. Thanks to them, I get to see Manini endure twice as much pain. I cannot control myself. Oh, you're so satisfying. Manini is one of my greatest accomplishments. Perhaps even my masterpiece. I suppose I can return this. I've held on to my little souvenir for quite some time. Tell him it's a little something to remember me by. The play is... Plays.
I'm not going back. I am sick of consuming Ergo. It's cruel. There's real meals and real songs out there. I'm not just a memory-reading tool.
What?
You're not the inspector? But if you're from the outside, that means we can leave. Thanks. I know the way out, so don't worry about me. Maybe I'll see you on the outside. I can read memories of Ergo. Ergo is crystallized time and memory. But God, I hate having to consume Ergo to read it. Why does it work like that? It's the worst. I can read memories, but I can't even dream of tastes, smells, or songs. I can't stand it anymore, so I'm escaping. When I get out, I'm going straight to Rosa Isabel Street. I can read memories of Ergo.
Ergo is
it's the
I can't.
You may not...